The heat pack contains equipment and instructions to help you understand your energy and water use at home. By understanding where you use the most energy and water, you can find ways to reduce it. Inside the pack, you will find an energy meter, an infrared thermometer, a light meter, a thermometer, and a water flow measuring cup. The energy meter measures how much electricity an appliance uses when it is switched on or using standby power. To use, simply plug the energy meter into the power socket, then plug your appliance into the meter. Turn on the power at the wall and on your appliance. On the energy meter, hold down the run button until you see the message on the screen, clear all data, then select yes. Press run again to start measuring. To work out the cost, energy or greenhouse gas emissions of the appliance you are testing when it is switched on, press the menu button until you see the screen you want. There are four lines of information. The top line shows the actual cost, energy used, emissions created to run your appliance since you switched it on and started measuring. The second line is the estimated cost, energy used, emissions created of your appliance per hour. The third line shows the estimated cost, energy used, emissions created after 3 months if you had your appliance switched on all the time. And the bottom line shows how much it cost, energy used, emissions created if your appliance is on all year. To work out the cost, energy or greenhouse gas emissions of the appliance you are testing when it is switched off, turn your appliance off. Hold down the run button until you see the message on the screen, clear all data, then select yes. Press run again to start measuring. This time you will see that the appliance is using a lot less energy and therefore costing less and emitting less emissions because it is switched off. But even switched off, the appliance uses a little bit of power. This is standby power, and when left on all the time, can start to add up, particularly if you calculate it over a year. Switching your power source off should save money, energy, and greenhouse gas emissions. By pointing it at walls and windows, you can measure the surface temperature and see if you are losing or gaining heat, both of which can be fixed with gap sealing, insulation, or shade. We point the thermometer at the window and press the trigger. On the screen, you can see the temperature of the window. Now point the thermometer at the wall and compare temperatures. In winter, the window is much cooler due to the low outdoor temperature. This shows that it is less insulated than the wall and lets the cold into your room more easily. If we close the curtains and measure the temperature, you will see that it is already a bit warmer, making it cozier inside, and our heater doesn't have to use so much energy to keep the room warm. In summer, you will find that the window is hotter than the wall as the high outdoor temperature heats it up. Closing the indoor curtains will help keep the room cool, and external shades stop the sun heating up the window directly, which can be very important on the north and west facing sides of your home. The infrared thermometer can also help you identify walls, ceilings, and floors that may need more insulation, and areas such as around windows and doors which need gap sealing. The light meter allows you to measure and compare light levels around your home. This way, you can find out if you can be using less artificial light to safely undertake your daily activities. Remove the flat cover to reveal the round white circle. Turn the dial to a setting of 2000. A number should now appear on the screen, telling you the lux rating of this area. check the rating against the table in the kit's instruction booklet to see if you could reduce the amount of artificial light by choosing a weaker strength bulb or reducing the number of bulbs in the area. The speed and volume of water coming out of your taps can be adjusted if it is too high, so that you don't waste water. The water flow measuring cup can help you decide. Move the cup handles so they are together and touching. Turn the tap onto the regular flow that you will use to wash your hands. Hold the cup under flowing water until it is overflowing out of the cup. Keep the cup under the water flow and slowly move the handles of the cup away from each other until the water remains level with the top of the cup. The cup is full but not overflowing. Once the water level of the cup is remaining a stable level in the cup, you can turn the tap off. Be careful not to move the handles in any way. Read the numbers on the side of the cup to find out the flow rate of the tap. The numbers on the cup stand for litres per minute. If the flow rate of the tap is more than 9 litres per minute, an easy way to save water is by installing a flow restrictor on the tap. This means that less water will fit through the tap, preventing too much from being wasted. We hope this helps you to find out how energy efficient your home is, saving you money and helping the environment. The heat packs are available to borrow from Mill Park, Laylaw or Thomastown Libraries.